Good morning, class. Welcome to the online classes. In the previous session, we have seen about the magnetic materials and we have differentiated that what were the origin for the magnetic materials like paramagnetic, diamagnetic and the ferromagnetic substance. What we have seen that different type of substance are present, that is the solid states which are present in our earth are of three different types, that is the substance which are repelling to the magnet, some they used to attract but with a less attraction or the feeble magnetism is there, and some are the substance which get highly attracted towards the magnet, that is they tend to move towards the magnet itself, right? So the according to this properties that how they repel and how they attract to the magnet, they were classified into three types, that is a diamagnetic substance, paramagnetic substance, ferromagnetic substance. And if you talk about paramagnetism, diamagnetism and the ferromagnetism, these are the properties of that substance, and the substance which will be showing those properties will be known as the diamagnetic substance, paramagnetic substance and ferromagnetic substance. So what was the diamagnetic substance? That used to show a very low magnetization, and that too in the opposite direction of the magnetizing field, right? That is what magnetizing field is given by M, and the magnetizing field intensity is given by H, and the intensity of the magnetization is given by capital M, right? So what they used to show a feeble magnetism, that is a less magnetism, that too in the absence of the external magnetic field, you can say that you are not applying any external magnetic field and it is just opposing to the direction of the magnetic field. So they tend to move from the stronger part to that of the weaker part, because they are repelling, so they are moving from the stronger to the weaker part. Similarly, paramagnetic substance without the external magnetic field also, what they used to do, they develop some magnetism but it will be too low, and that will be in the direction of magnetic field. So what we can say, they are in the direction of the magnetic field and they are showing some magnetism also. Magnetization means they are showing a low magnetization, but what they will do, they will try to attract towards the magnet and will try to move from a weaker part to the stronger part. And what we have seen in the example, that is aluminium, chromium, sodium, okay. And similarly, what were the ferromagnetic, that shows the strong magnetization in the direction of the magnetic field. So they are strongly attracted by the magnets and tend to move from the weaker part to that of the stronger part of the magnetic field. And this was the examples of like iron, cobalt, nickel, that shows the strongest magnetism, right? They used to show the strongest magnetization. Similarly, we have seen that these properties like diamagnetism, paramagnetism and the ferromagnetism, that how they get origin, right? We have seen that electrons around the nucleus, they used to revolve and they used to rotate in their axis also. So what you are in that figure, we have seen that they are moving in the clockwise direction and that other electron will be doing in the anticlockwise direction. If they both are a pair of electrons, if some elements used to have the two pairs of electrons and one of them will be moving in the clockwise direction and the other one will be moving in the anticlockwise direction. Now, if the electrons which are placed in the magnetic field B, then that speed of revolution may be increase or decrease. So one pair will be increasing its velocity and another will be decreasing its velocity, and it is given that the magnetic moment will may be changing in something and someone will be increasing its magnetic moment, so other pair will be increasing it. So we can say that together they are pair of net magnetic moment of these electrons that you are seeing in the figure, that they are orbiting around a nucleus and they produce a magnetic moment. Okay, they produce a magnetic moment, that too in the two opposite direction, that one will be having the more magnetic moment and other will be having the decreased magnetic moment. So M plus del M and M minus del M, so together they will be showing 2 del M. Okay, so we can say that the diamagnetic substance, that's why they used to repel there and they move from the stronger to the weaker part of the magnet. So sufficient magnetic moment is there in the diamagnetic substance but in the opposite direction of the magnetic field, that's why they used to be repelled from the magnet. Okay, and that is the paramagnetism, that is origin of the paramagnetism. If you talk here, you can see the diagrams, that is the atomic dipoles which are present in the atom. If you talk it in the presence of the magnetic field, that is if the atoms are present in the presence of the external magnetic field also, you can see that the magnetic moment used to change. So what here happens, that the try to possess a permanent magnetic moment, they are trying to possess a permanent magnetic moment. If there is no magnetic field, then what we can see here, that the atomic dipoles are just trying to move in the random condition. They are in the randomly distributed, right? They are randomly distributed and moving in the random direction. So when we apply an external magnetic field, what they try to align, and that too in the direction of a magnetic field. So they try to align themselves in the direction of magnetic field, due to which the spin of electrons, they will not cancel each other. So what we can say that atomic dipoles, in the absence of external magnetic field, they will be randomly orient themselves, or they move in the random direction. But if we talk that if we apply or we are seeing that magnetic field in the presence of it, then these atomic dipoles which are moving in the random situation, they used to make themselves aligned in the direction of the magnetic field. So we can say that in the absence of the external field, there will be no net magnetization. But if we talk that in the presence of the magnetic field, then we can say that the temperature should be low enough and the magnetic field should be applied with a high, that a high value should be applied for the, a strong magnetic field can be applied. So here, to align the atomic dipole in its own direction, they try to move or align themselves in the direction of the magnetic field, but they cannot show the strong magnetization. They are showing a very feeble magnetization, that is low magnetization, and they try to move from a weaker to the stronger end of the region, or the stronger end, you can say stronger region of the magnet. But what they are trying to, they are trying to align themselves in the direction. So whether we are talking about a diamagnetic or a paramagnetic, here we are talking about the domains and the electrons. But what there happened, that the magnetic moment may changes, and this magnetic moment changes, and they were directly proportional to that of the magnetic field. And since they are in the opposite direction, so they try to move in the different direction to that of the magnetic field. And these different directions, what we can say, that it is repelled by a magnetic, and this behavior of this magnetic materials was said to be the diamagnetism. And in that, it was independent of temperature. Here it is dependent, but very low temperature is there and very high magnetic fields are allowed. Okay, so this magnetization approaches its maximum value when these atomic dipole moments are there. Here these atomic dipole moments, that when they get aligned in the direction of the magnetic field, then only what we can say, they appear to its maximum value, that is magnetization appears to its maximum value. And what they used to, they try to move from the weaker end to that of the stronger end, or the region of the magnet. Okay, and thereafter we have seen the Curie's law also, that the temperature was very low in the paramagnetic substance and the magnetization is very high. So from seeing this, the paramagnetic material, so Curie gave an did an experiment, and he gave a relation that magnetization, what the magnetizing field intensity is there, that is H, and the intensity of the magnetization field, it is taken as M. So intensity of magnetization and the magnetic field intensity H, they are directly proportional to each other. That is, how much the magnetizing field intensity will be there, that the intensity of the magnetization will be of that material. So they are directly proportional to each other. But we have seen that very high magnetic field will have a very low temperature. So it is inversely proportional to that of the T. And after taking out this proportional sign, we will get the equal sign, due to which a Curie's constant will come, that is C. And what this C will be showing you, that is M upon H will be equal to C upon T. So this C upon T, what you can say, that is the constant of the Curie. And this M upon H, we know that it is given for the chi. And for mu, that is magnetic permeability, it is given by B by H. Chi is given, that is susceptibility, chi m, for that is the intensity of the magnetization, is given for the magnetic susceptibility, that is chi m, which was equals to C by T. What does it mean? That the temperature is inversely proportional to that of the susceptibility. That susceptibility of a paramagnetic material is just inversely proportional to its temperature. That is, if the temperature increases to that point where this atomic dipoles try to align themselves in the direction of the magnetic field, so there are the point where it will be losing its Curie's law. So Curie law will be till that reason where that they are aligned, or they are trying to align themselves in the direction of the magnetic field. After that, the saturation region will come, because it reaches its maximum value for the magnetization. Okay, and what we have seen about the ferromagnetism property, that the domains which are present are atomic dipoles, in the absence of the external magnetic field, the domains were randomly distributed. So the net magnetic moment was zero, similar to that of the paramagnetism. But when the, we know that for the paramagnetic substance, when it is kept here, the net magnetic moment was zero. Similarly, same for that of the ferromagnetic system, that is randomly oriented. But when we take it in the magnetic field, what the domains used to they align themselves along the direction of the magnetic field, and they are tend to move from the strong magnetization to the weak magnetization region. So what we can say that are aligning themselves very fast, so they will be strongly attracted by that of the magnet. Okay, so what we can say, they used to move in the direction like if you can see the figure, wait, this one you can see that how they are moving, that is the when the magnet is zero, that is B is given as zero, the magnetic field is in the absent here. Here how they are moving, that they are moving or aligning themselves in the go inside, that is they are moving in the opposite directions, they are decreasing in the size, right? So what we can say, when the external field is weak, the domain in the direction of the magnetic field, they will be growing in the size, and if the magnetic field is less, then what we can say, they are decreased in the size. Okay, so what they are happening, see, growing of the domains, are their domains are growing because magnetic field is less. If it takes a strong magnetic field, what they will do, they will increase the rotation of the domains, there will be rotation, that is when the external field is strong, the domains try to rotate and get aligned in the direction of the magnetic field itself. You can see here, right? So as the Curie's law were given according to the paramagnetic substance, similarly here the for the ferromagnetic substance, Weyl also come for the law, that is Curie and the Weyl together gives the law, Curie Weyl law. So the temperature at which the ferromagnetic substance becomes paramagnetic substance, that is they will be showing a feeble attraction towards the magnet, at that point it is said to be the Curie temperature or the Curie point. So the absolute temperature at where this ferromagnetic substance are getting aligned themselves in the direction of the magnetic field, and if you take that Curie's temperature, then difference of this will give you the temperature where this ferromagnetic materials are getting into the paramagnetic materials. So we know that from the Curie's law that it is chi m is equals to c upon t minus t. It was c upon t, but for c it was Curie's constant. Here if we talk about the Curie's temperature also, then it will be t minus tc. Okay, so Curie's temperature, that is inversely proportional to the temperature that is above the Curie's temperature. Okay, this ferromagnetic substance above the Curie temperature, they will be not working, so they will be trying to move fast, so they will be aligning themselves very fast. Okay, so above the Curie temperature will be that the susceptibility inversely proportional to that of the Curie's temperature. Okay, what are the example, that is iron, cobalt, nickel. Okay, now today we will be seeing that the properties of the diamagnetic substance, that what were the properties and diamagnetic, paramagnetic, ferromagnetic substance, that whenever the external magnetic field is applied or whenever we place these objects in the external magnetic field, what we have seen that they used to develop a very less magnetization, that too in the opposite direction of the magnetic field, they act in the opposite direction, so they get repelled from the magnetic or the magnet, and they move or they try to align themselves in the opposite direction of the magnetic field, right? So what we can say, diamagnetic material placed in a magnetic field are never be in the direction of the magnetic field, they will be trying to induce themselves in the direction opposite to the direction of the magnetic field. Okay, so we can say that the magnetic induction B, that is inside the material, become less than that of the magnetizing field. So this is shown for you that this magnetizing field will become less than that of the magnetic induction, right? And what else was there, that when it is placed in the uniform, that is it was uniform, but if you take it as non-uniform magnetic field, then the diamagnetic substance, they will be trying to move it from the stronger to the weaker. Why? Because uniform magnetic field, they were trying to oppose the magnetic field, now they will be trying to move in the direction of the magnetic field itself, right? So this indicates that the field is stronger in that of the near the poles. Or if you take a diamagnetic substance and try to suspend it freely, then it tries to align perpendicular to the magnetizing field. So this is one of the property that will try to set itself in the direction perpendicular to the magnetizing field. Similarly, what we have learned, that the relative permeability, म्यू आर रिलेटिव इज गिवन बाय म्यू अपॉन म्यू नॉट, दैट इज एब्सोल्यूट परमेबिलिटी अपॉन परमेबिलिटी, दस म्यू अपॉन म्यू नॉट परमेबिलिटी अपॉन एब्सोल्यूट परमेबिलिटी, विच इज गिवन एज वन प्लस काई एम, एंड दिस इज पॉजिटिव सो इट विल बी अ पैरामैग्नेट, इफ इट इज नेगेटिव और लेस देन वन दैन इट इज मैग्नेटिक सब्सटेंस, इट विल बी हैविंग द वैल्यू प्लस इट सेल्फ, पॉजिटिव वैल्यू विल बी देयर बट इट विल बी लेस देन वन इट सेल्फ, सो इट इज फॉर द डायमैग्नेटिक. ओके, सिमिलरली वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द पैरामैग्नेटिक सब्सटेंस ऑल्सो, दैट वन प्लेस्ड इन एक्सटर्नल मैग्नेटिक फील्ड दे डेवलप अ लेस मैग्नेटाइजेशन बट इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड इट सेल्फ, राइट. So here the magnetic induction becomes greater than that. Here what we have read that the magnetic induction is lesser than that of the magnetizing field. Here the magnetic induction will be slightly, very slightly less greater than that of the magnetizing field. That's why they are trying to align themselves in the stronger part of the magnet, right? So they have the more magnetic induction than that of the magnetizing field. And when we place it in a non-uniform magnetic field, because we are placed in the non-uniform magnetic field, that diamagnetic substance, they try to attract towards the magnet. When we place it in the non-uniform, now they will be changing its direction, that is from the weaker to the stronger they were moving. Now they will be moved from the weaker to that of the stronger part of the class. Similarly, they do the same, but they will be trying to change the speed also. And if you talk about the free suspension of this paramagnetic substance, because the diamagnetic substance, when they are freely suspended, they try to make themselves perpendicular to that of the two poles, north and the south poles. Similarly, in the magnetic field, when they are suspended freely, so they try to align themselves in the parallel to that of the magnetizing field. So where the magnetizing field direction will be, it will be parallel. And there we have seen the magnetizing field where it is perpendicular to it. Right? And here the Curie's law will also come, that is, chi or susceptibility is inversely proportional to the temperature, and Curie's constant C is to come. Okay, so now we will be seeing the properties of the ferromagnetic substance, the substance which shows the stronger magnetization in the direction of the magnetic field. So whenever it is placed in the external magnetic field, they will be showing the strong magnetization, that too in the direction of the external magnetic field. Now when it is placed in the magnetic field, you can say that the induction is too much more than that of the magnetizing field. That's why they are getting attracted very fast to that of the magnetic field, right? They get to get very much attracted towards the magnetic field, or in the moves in the direction of the magnetic field, right? So that's why they used to have their magnetic induction more than that of the magnetizing field. And when this ferromagnetic substance I kept in the non-uniform magnetic field, it moves from the weaker to the stronger part of the field itself, right? And we know that whenever a ferromagnetic substance will suspend easily, or we can say freely, in a uniform magnetic field, they will try to move it parallel direction itself, because both of them attract, try to show the magnetization, and they attract towards the magnet. But some paramagnetic substance have their low magnetization, feeble magnetization is there. Here it is low, it is more than that of the paramagnetic substance, it is more. So what we can say, that this one or that one, they will be trying to align themselves parallel to that of the magnetizing field, and they will be having the high value for the magnetic induction than that of the magnetizing field intensity. Okay, so we can say this M is 2 greater than that of the H, so value of the chi will also be greater. Okay, so here we will be seeing that difference between the paramagnetic, diamagnetic in a tabular form, so that you can understand very easily. That is the effects of magnet, what we've seen, that it is getting magnetized but in the opposite direction of the magnetic field, and they try to repel themselves from the magnet. So they are having a very feeble magnetization in the opposite direction of the field. If you talk about paramagnetic, it shows the magnetization but they get less attracted towards the magnet, and they shows the magnetization in the direction of the magnetic field but it will be very less. Okay, similarly they are always strongly attracted by that of the magnets, that is, they are showing a strong magnetization in the direction of the magnetic field. Now we have seen that when we apply the external magnetic field, then what they used to, they try to move away from the stronger part to that of the weaker, and this both what they will do, the paramagnetic field showing the less magnetization but in the direction of magnetic field, and that one they will be showing the strong magnetization in the direction of the magnetic field. So they, what they used to, they both used to try to tend themselves move from the weaker part to that of the stronger part of the field, and here they will be moving from the strong to the weaker part, right? And we have seen that whenever we suspend freely that paramagnetic, diamagnetic and the ferromagnetic substance, what they use to, they align themselves in the perpendicular direction. That is, the diamagnetic substance try to align themselves in the perpendicular direction to that of the magnetizing field. Similarly, paramagnetic and the ferromagnetic, they try to align themselves parallel to that of the magnetizing field. Okay, and we have seen that the value of the diamagnetic substance for the permeability, relative permeability, it will be less than 1, but not will be negative. And here you can say it is more than 1 will be positive. And mu r, that for the ferromagnet is too large value and it will be highest positive value. And for susceptibility, we have seen that it will be smaller susceptibility, or there will be negative value. And for here, it will be positive. And that one, it will be having large positive value for the susceptibility. Okay. And we have seen that it is independent of temperature. That is, diamagnetic substance are independent of temperature. Similarly, in that paramagnetic substance, we have seen that Curie's law C upon T. There, it was inversely proportional to that of the temperature. And if we talk about ferromagnetic substance, then it is inversely proportional, but the temperature of that substance should be greater than that of the Curie's temperature. Okay. And if it say that if you take out that magnetic field from there, or the magnetization last, then the magnetizing field is applied only till that the magnet will behave as a diamagnetic substance. And if you remove for the paramagnetic substance, now they will be having a small magnetization, but they will lost. It will also lost in a second. But if you think of the ferromagnetic substance, after removing also they will be showing the magnetization. So this is what the slighter changes in this diamagnetic, paramagnetic and the ferromagnetic substance. If you talk about M and H, they will be changing linearly. Here the M changes, but try to attain the saturation at a lower temperature, that is Curie's temperature, and the magnetic field will be very strong. Similarly, ferromagnetic substance M changes, but they are not linear. They will be attain saturation very fastly. And if you talk about the hysteresis effect, we will be talking later, because next topic will be hysteresis. There we will be seeing. So formation or the physical state of the diamagnetic substance, what we can say, the diamagnetic substance are always in solid, liquid or gas format. And that paramagnetic, it can also be a element, compound, solid, liquid, gas, anything. And talk about physical state for the ferromagnetic, they are always a solid. Okay, that is iron, nickel, cobalt, they will always show the highest strong magnetizing field. Okay, so in the next class, we will be seeing the hysteresis curve. Okay, so thank you, class.